why'd you stop? He don't like to pass the ball. I wonder where that low is at. It was me against the wall. I was out here running plays. Guess it paid off after all. 13 bad girl. Her hat just got a star. She got a stitch and I got a stitches. We won't be sparing you. Chasing who? Pursuing who? I won't be chasing you. I'm 4-1. I lost the cap. I'ma charge it to the game. 4-3-8 is not a game. It's just a music thing. Last player got out his lane. Put right back in his lane. I'ma sit that pat when I get to Cali. Hope it gets sent back over. Rain in your range. Ain't send no players. All I'm getting ran over. Don't spare mine. Gonna spare yours when I'm doing this game over. Only been rapping for like 4 months. Now they play a time over. They talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all. Cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty. Wonder how he felt watching his dog Cassie fall. I had to tell my wife to stop. He don't like to pass the ball.
Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's the cloud and hit is mad. You can never be a subject, carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I played it. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placed. I got choices, I'm getting opinions from so many folks to bring the horses. So I can get up away from all the noise. Too many people tell me what I should do. I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I mess up for my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do?
First opened back in 1975, there's a look inside the iconic Superdome in downtown New Orleans. The setup. Back in 1975, there's a look inside the iconic Caesars Superdome in downtown New Orleans.
This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle
with the Washington football team.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Down, love to pass.
He's going to drop this one down to Gibson.
He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Second down and 3. The first carry for the Memphis man, Antonio Gibson.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Good sign here early. Everybody on offense there up front in the backfield in sync on that play.
So much talk about what do you do to neutralize home field advantage. Well, teams that run the football effectively, they often have a way of neutralizing it in a big way when they have those types of runs.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Love, they go play action now. Oh, this is going to be caught along the sidelines. Probably shouldn't have been caught. He's going to lose yardage there. And early on, they're picking up right where they left off last week.
And I know a lot of coaches say each game is its own. You don't really have carryover. This feels like carryover. So much confidence from the previous game that they're using to their advantage now.
On first and 10, it's Gibson.
He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards.
Well, sometimes it's hard to take your eyes off this guy at the linebacker position. He can really cover some ground, and he did there to make that play.
And sometimes all of your best laid plans of play design, your X's and O's, they can't always account for individual effort defensively. And this was one of those times. Just a terrific play to hustle over there and get the running back to the ground.
And the final clocking on the next-gen stats, look at this, 22.3 miles an hour was his top speed.
First down, Washington.
And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Gibson.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Handoff running left is Gibson.
A nice lift. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington.
Antonio Gibson with touchdown number 23 here on the year. And Washington takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
The first carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one.
I tell you what, CD, this Washington defense, very strong in the victory last week.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and try to attack them this week, because when you take it away four times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
Off play action, Huggins. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 40. What a great start. You get the points on the first drive of the game. Now here you get an interception. Look to add to your lead.
And I just wonder about the strategy we saw coming right back at them. Yeah, they're down, but it felt like they were pressing it too much. They didn't need to play catch-up this early in the game, and it ended up costing them.
First down, it's Gibson, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Sometimes being a linebacker in the middle of the field is kind of like being a doctor on the field. You got to make the right diagnosis. Here he correctly sends his run and shoots through to make the play in the backfield.
On second and 11 now, Love. This is caught. It's Brown. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there.
And a short pickup there down to about the 9. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. Shotgun handoff to Gibson. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. This is kind of one of those in-between plays here, Charles, on third and goal from the 2 or the 3 in that area. What do you dial up?
Something quick hitting. You don't have the time for something that develops slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football. And if you're going to throw it, something quick, get it out of your hands in a hurry.
The crowd here in the dome making things difficult. Third and goal. Firing quickly out wide is Love. Touchdown, Washington. A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And Washington going to add on to their lead.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And it's now 14 to nothing.
Saints nothing.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Following the penalty, it's Kamara. They had a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16.
Kamara, the ball carrier. Jonathan Allen on the tackle. A gain of two. Brings up second.
To throw on second down. Huggins. And Bolden brings it in. Complete. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Looking to throw. Huggins. That's complete to Bolden. Oh, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down. 55 is my guy, 55. They'll try and throw for it here. Looking for Bolden, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. And he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. It's good, and before you know it, it's 21-0.
Makes this Washington 21, Saints nothing.
So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
Kamara, and he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Washington territory. After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
It's a gain of five, brings up second and five.
Back to throw, Huggins. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Montez Sweat able to record his fifth sack of the season. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. A couple of extra defensive bats in the ballgame here on third and six. Looking to throw, Huggins. They'll get this out to Kamara. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Back to throw. Huggins. And the Washington pressure gets to him, and he will go down. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Now it's Kamara in the passing game. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. The Saints on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Back to Kamara for another catch. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
It's a gain of 11. That's another.
Throwing on first down, Huggins. Well, I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. Down right around the 25. Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down.
Brings up 3rd down and 9.
Looking to throw. Huggins. And that is incomplete.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple of big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up 4th down.
Out now is the field goal unit for New Orleans. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. The kick by Lutz is good. And the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. So 3 drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
So if you're an offensive coordinator and you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong lot of work, aren't you? You got to find a way to unlock the key to these defenses and put some big points on the board.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
You know, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? Where everything is working for them, every move they make works, it clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. On first down, right back to Gibson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 88 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A handoff for Gibson. Despite the strong run, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
Complete out to Samuel on the quick throw.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think a guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they were supposed to be doing something else. But bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
And he's going to get this inside the 30.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
They'll run here with Gibson. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12 at the 29-yard line.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. On second down, a run with Gibson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called. They are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a third and three. They'll run with Gibson, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
A 40-yard attempt.
And Gay knocks this one through, and the lead up to 3 touchdowns now. It's 24-3. So everything else has gone right in this first half. Kind of follows that it would for their kicker, too, as he adds 3 more onto the lead.
Yeah, and the way that this one's gone, definitely not looking like he's going to have to worry too much about pressure kicks late in the game. He can go out there free and easy, just work on his form, and he knocked that one through.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw again, Huggins. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It's been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series. And they need a big adjustment here to try to put some points on the board.
And he fires one incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Back to throw, Huggins. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Blake Gillikin on to punt now on 4th down. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. A 40-yard punt, no return, and control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And with a 3-score lead already, this is not time for a momentum change, so I'd imagine they'd be happy to just take this into the locker room.
And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half.
Coming up on a 2nd and 6.
They'll keep it on the ground again here.
And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
So we have come upon halftime, and it's the visiting group from Washington who are out on top.
As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number 3. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They start the second half with Kamara. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line.
It's a gain of 11. And the Saints.
On first down, Huggins. That's complete, Bernard. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Looking to throw, Huggins. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 43.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point, and what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue, not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a first down.
A run for Kamara on first down, but the running room closes up quickly as he's only able to get a yard there.
A gain of a yard.
Looking to throw on second down, Huggins, and they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
The passing windows are just not there, and that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
The line to gain is the 33 on third down. Back to throw, Huggins. And he comes back with one complete.
And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
First down. First and 10 at the 23-yard line.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Looking to throw, Huggins. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25.
A small bit of adversity here on what's been a strong drive as they come up 2nd and 12.
And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Washington defense.
It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this 3rd quarter.
Behind the chain, 2nd and 12.
Watch the screen. Pass. 55.
A 10th carry for Kamara. And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. No gain that time, and it leaves him with 3rd and 11 coming up.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, Huggins. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man. And he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
122 yards rushing for him now as his big night continues. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30.
A few moving pieces on that play because that was an RPO, was it not?
It was, but one important piece that didn't move incorrectly, the offensive line. Because when you're running this play, as he continued down the line of scrimmage, sometimes the lineman can wander downfield. And if you're more than a yard downfield, it's illegal to throw the football at that point. But they held their ground, held their spot, and turned it into a nice game.
He continues to have a big night here under the lights carrying the football.
And some guys prefer night games for whatever reason. Their bodies react a certain way. They love the spotlight. Maybe that's what it is. The best seats in the house, the ones where he's carrying the football for his offensive teammates. The worst seats, the 11 guys trying to tackle him on defense.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and make sure nothing could get to the outside. But he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
On second down, it's Gibson. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14. On play action. Love to throw. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. They do get 12, but they'll be marked short. And that leads to a fourth down. But not before he takes it inside the 40. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
He's having a big game running the football, but that one will hurt the yards per carry a little bit.
Yeah, but the average he's got so far, that's the type of average he wants to take with him to contract negotiations, doesn't he?
Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up.
Once more, Gibson.
And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
On third down, here's Gibson.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. That'll be good for six, but now it's fourth down. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. Gay's kick is good. And that will extend the lead out to 24.
So this drive maybe didn't end with the same kind of success they had in the first half, but they do add three to their lead.
And defensively, I think they went in there at halftime and made a pact with each other and said, look, we can't let these guys keep driving it right down our throats. Not perfect giving up three, but a much better start than the way they played in the first half.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
3 yards remain for second down.
Back to throw. Huggins going up top. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off near the 42. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Another solid game-changing play for this defense with the interception. At this point, though, I don't know that it's game-changing. I mean, they've got this one in firm control.
And you always hear about, you know, those stories about someone left their game plan behind and maybe you benefit from it. I'm not going to say that that happened, but they certainly have appeared on defense to be a step ahead this entire game. Guys are always in the right spot in order to make a play.
The offense has had its moments, too.
And, oh, that nearly their first pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Love.
He'll check that down to Gibson out of the backfield.
And he gets us down inside the 35 before going out of bounds.
Well, partner, nothing but praise for me for this offense. They have been tremendous all night long. They knew what they had to do to unlock the defense. And let's face it, this has been a master class in offensive football that we've been here to witness.
Play fake. Here's Love.
He's got Mason complete. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Play action this time with Love. Going for it all.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington.
A great play there. With his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And this Washington offense continuing to add to their lead.
And
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead will swell by one more.
Saints 3.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big-time play there for New Orleans.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
Now here's a throw that's complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
Saints, first down.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He'll get this one underneath to Kamara. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
It's second and inches at the 6-yard line.
Here's Kamara out of the pistol. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Alvin Kamara, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Saints are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. Lutz good on the extra point, and the lead is down to 24.
Saints 10. Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And it's looking all the more likely that a fifth straight win is going to be in the cards. They'll try to run some time here with a 1st and 10. And he'll just get back to the line of scrimmage, if that. And with a flag on the field, and that one looks to be in the area where someone was held. They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. Off the play fake, Love. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Something we haven't really seen much of from him, an incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass rush is usually the best way, because a quarterback on his back usually can't complete a pass.
On 2nd down now, it's Gibson. Shifts by him. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 143 yards on the ground for him so far.
And it brings up 3rd down.
Washington on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd down and 12. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he's going to be brought down short of the 1st at about the 31-yard line. They do get 9, but it leads to 4th down. Here's Tressway now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the 4th quarter. We'll call that a 43-yard punt, 2 on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. And boy, another ill-advised throw there, as that will wind up incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Eluding the pressure right. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
They go play action here on first down.
That's complete to Troutman right side. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
And Charles, with that completion, I'm told that puts him now over 3,000 yards passing on the campaign.
And Brandon, I think we have to start to think about where we are in the season, because right now, 4,000 is not out of the question. I think a big game or two, he's certainly capable of getting that done.
And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. On first and 10, Huggins. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
They'll look to throw now on first down. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them, because just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 28. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. That one looks like he'll throw here. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
Love, they go play action now. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's taken down inside the 30. 160 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he
gets hit, and he fumbles it.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost.
And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right.
And the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted.
Picked off by Paulson Adebo. And the Saints are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Boy, the coverage there airtight as he comes away with the interception.
Love that observation there because they were taking a shot in the end zone. But you're right about the coverage. Absolutely tremendous. And this they could clip for a training tape. Staying with him down the field, locates the football in the air, and comes away with the interception.
And he ran right through one tackle as he fights forward for a gain of 7.
So a victory here for the Washington football team.
And it was a game where they were off and running in the first quarter, Charles, and never looked back.
You know, partner, after a while, we always say the same thing, don't we? They set the tone early, right? They started fast. So I asked a few of my horse racing friends, do you have a term for me that we can use to cover that? And they said, yeah. When a horse breaks out like that, you say he caught a flyer out of the gate. And that's exactly what this team did today. I mean, they jumped out there, jumped on them, and were never headed.
So for one,